And of the remaining free Athenians, half, like me, were automatically disqualified. Women weren't just unequal, they were believed to be demonic, possessed by demones, spirits. They needed to be controlled, visibly restricted. In fact, the first hard evidence of the full face veil comes from Athens.
Women were not meant to be seen. All the evidence of vase painting would suggest that the woman is veiled. Mm. She has her cloak draped over her head.
Should we have a go? Sue Blundell is researching the status of women in Athenian society.
And just drape it over your arm like that. Then if you want to cover your face, you can go like that.
Yes.
Lovely.
Well, look, I match. Sophocles said, silence is the greatest ornament of the woman.
I feel nicely silent like that.
I hate it, it makes me feel really claustrophobic. The message that's being sent out is that a married woman is the possession of the man.
Yes, he is the one person in her life for whom she will unveil herself, yes.
It wasn't only Athens. Almost every society till the 20th century has been fiercely patriarchal. But there was, in that searing mass of experimentation, the possibility that something different could have been done. Where do we hear about that? We hear about it as a joke. Aristophanes imagines what would happen if women took over. We hear about it as philosophical thought. So Plato imagines what happens if we got rid of the family and had women as well as men as guardians of his republic.
But of course it didn't happen. Only the free men of Athens could belong to the democratic club, which met together on the Pnyx.
At dawn, Athenian citizens would come here to sit around on the bare rock and debate in the assembly how it was that they should run their own lives.